Hello, Facebook family and YouTube family and friends. This is Pamela Grace. I thank you for subscribing to my YouTube channel. I'm going to start a new playlist, and it's going to be devoted to hymns. I'm going to do a contemporary feel, like a beatbox with the hymns. I might do something else to use another music genre just to introduce the hymn. Going to do a break it down for me. I'll give you an example of that tonight. And I'll do a brief lesson on some of the stanzas so that we can gain a renewed appreciation for the hymns that were inspired by God for different various people to write so that it would enrich our lives and give us an opportunity to think of the goodness of God and to worship and praise Him individually and in our corporate settings. Today, I posted a beatbox to the song by Willian Cowper. He wrote this in 1774. It's entitled, God Moves in Mysterious Ways. Interesting to note that when this man wrote this, this was shortly after he had attempted suicide, and this was another a failed attempt at suicide, yet he writes this beautiful hymn. And by the way, he wrote also, there's a fountain filled with blood. So let's look at the first stanza and let me break it down for you. So I'm not going to really do a scriptural analysis in this particular one. This is a break it down for you when I take the stilted language and I just kind of break it down to what he's really saying or what I think he's really saying. It goes like this, the first stanza. God moves in a mysterious way, his wonders to perform. He plants his footsteps in the sea and rides upon the storm. God moves in a mysterious way. Think about that. We know God moves. You know, there's a William Blackaby wrote a series entitled Experiencing God, a wonderful biblical study, like, and what is God doing? Because God is always at work and he's wanting to work through us. So God is moving. He is not dead. He is not static. He is not idle in ways you don't understand it. Don't get it misconstrued. Don't get it twisted. Just because you can't see it, just because you don't understand it. And please stop blaming some stuff on the devil when God is moving, causing all things to work together for your good, perfecting that concerns you. And I'm saying, okay, I said I was just going to break it down for you, not use the scriptural reference. It's hard to not do that. So basically God was saying, don't get it twisted. You ain't gonna understand what I'm doing. You can't get to this. You know, my thoughts are not your thoughts. My mind is not your mind. God moves in mysterious ways, his wonders to perform. It's his wonders to perform. He moves in mysterious ways so that in a way it's for his wonders to perform, because there's no way to do it. There's no other way. It's a mystery and it's a wonder. God is a wonder to perform. And then it said he plants his feet. It said he plants his feet on the sea and rides upon the storm. Now, William Cowper from England, and England was a super naval power in 1774. Yeah, that was before 1775, so they still had their stakes in America. And the U.S., they owned the colonies. They had just won a war with France, and so they owned Canada. They're coming across and fighting the French and defeating Indians and putting sending people out. They were making money. Their naval power, they're in the West Indies, and they're in Africa. They've got a lot of wealth. So this visual picture would be very common to look at it, but it's also a scriptural visual picture too, because Jesus also plants his footsteps on the sea and he rides upon the storm. Because remember, Peter was trying not to fall, you know, and he wanted to follow Jesus out on as he walked on water. So here's this image. He's just saying that this man, he can walk on water. God can walk on water. He plants his footsteps. It's not, you know, when you plant your footsteps, normally it's on a surface, you know, but he said, our God is so awesome. This is not even a surface, but he plants his footsteps. So what is moving around him? This is a mystery. How can things be moving? And yet he is still in control. He rides upon the storm like This is nothing to our God. Deep. And let me go here. I'm going to move this over to my computer so I can see this here. It says deep and unfathomable minds. When you can't even like minds where you're there's things, resources and stuff in the back you can't get to this, but deep in minds, because a mind is kind of deep. Deep and unfathomable of minds of never failing skill. God never fails, never failing. So deep and unfathomable minds of never failing skill. This is the resources you can't even imagine of always delivering, always being, always having everything that is needed. He's a great I am that I am. I said I was going to use this as a teaching lesson. I just wanted to break it down to you. And he says he treasures up and his work is sovereign still. So he treasures up his designs and his work is sovereign still. So his work is sovereign, meaning God is like, it was already predestined. It's already a done deal. I planned this. I am not surprised. COVID, I am not surprised. I am aware of this. I'm the maker and creator of all things. So even in this, okay, God has got this. I want to encourage you. See, here's the other part of this scripture. I want to, not scripture, but the hymn. Okay, it says, ye fearful saints, fresh courage take. So, saints, wow. Fearful. He said, fearful saints, ye fearful saints, come on, get a grip. Come on, scary cats. Come on, you know, man up on this thing. Let's get serious because you're saints, but you're fearful. So, but if you're saints, you're connected to God and you're fearful. Come on, get real. Stop all that. Get your undies out of a wad. He's saying, you fearful saints, courage take. Get a grip. This is like a spiritual slap. Hello, wake up. Come on, light bulb, go to, your light bulb turn on, elevator go to the top. Stop being fearful because this is of never. He says, the clouds, you so much dread. So the clouds, now come on. The clouds, this that brings rain and refreshment and what we need to the land to restore itself, to replenish itself. Water is, you know, a part of life. And so these clouds that you see from your perspective, these clouds, ye so dread. Now nobody says, oh, I dread that. Oh, I dread going there. I don't like going there. I'm thinking on my last room. I don't like that. You know, I'm uneasy with that. I'm not comfortable with that. That's what how we talk. So we don't say, I'm dreading that. Oh, I'm dreading going to my prom or I'm dreading my first day. We don't talk like that. But basically it says the thing that makes you like, ooh, cringe and recoil and want to pull back. Ye fearful saints, fresh, fresh. You mean get this real, get this right, get this new, get this pure. Get fresh courage, not the old courage, because the stuff you're dealing with, you got to get fresh courage. Renew yourself. Get revitalized. The clouds you so much dread. Now, here's the beauty. Are big with mercy and shall break. Wow. In blessings on your head. In blessings on your head. That's what, if you listen to the beatbox, you'll hear me doing a little bit of that. Having fun with that hymn. But watch this. Big. So these clouds that you see are clouds. Look again. They're big with mercy. So just see that cloud like a mercy cloud, a lace cloud. So no, whatever comes out of that cloud, because he loves you, there's mercy in this cloud because we know his mercies are new every morning. New every morning. His steadfast love never ceases. And they shall break with blessings on your head. Now, normally, it's gonna come down your head. It's, you ain't gonna like, you're gonna feel that, whoa, that hit my head, boom. When the thought comes to your head, you know, the light bulb comes on. He said, oh, this is not going on your shoulders. He's not talking about your feet. But blessings, it's like an anointing. It's like when you knight somebody, it's coming to the top of your head. So he said, the clouds are big with mercies. and blessings on your head. So get real. Don't get your undies in a wad. This is basically what this is saying. You can break this down to the three stanzas. It's actually three more stanzas. I'll share with it that on another day. But he says, basically saying, don't get your undies in a wad. What looks like bad is going to be okay. It's going to be good. Now, this man wrote this after he tried to commit suicide. There's a lot more to William Cowper's story. He had lost his mother. He was orphaned as a child. He had spent some time in different schools for poor kids too, and perhaps was treated poorly, losing his mother. So if you've been orphaned, or you've lost your mom, or if you've thought about suicide, to think that God has something inside of you that's going to refresh you, that's going to restore you. And whether it's something you write down, you journal, a prayer you write, or something you sing, maybe it might be something that a song someone writes. God is still working. So no matter what you're going through, God is still wanting to minister to you and minister through you. So don't get your undies in a wad. God got this. Be encouraged. Have a great day.